I am going to tell you now, you are never, ever going to make any money trading if you're waiting for your dream bank size. Okay. My name is Ryan Grovers from the betfairtradingcommunity.com, and I produce videos like this on a weekly basis. So does Martin, to help you get better at trading. So if you are new to this channel, hit subscribe, like, and make sure you hit that bell so that you can always get notified. If you are not new and you haven't subscribed or got the bell notifications, what are you doing? Get them, because I'm going to bring so much energy every single week, and also with all of my other videos, to your YouTube dashboard, and we are going to get you better at trading. Okay. I also have a really handy trader quiz. I'll put a comment, a link to that in the description below. Okie dokie. So what am I talking about here? Well, I get this question every single day. When I have £2,000 in my Betfair account, I will finally be able to make enough money to, that'll be my dream bank. I'll have enough money to start trading, or I'll have enough money to make what I want to live, to hit my trading goals. It's wrong. It's total bull, okay? Because you will never, ever, 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 ever be a successful trader if you're waiting for that dream bank. Because the markets are mechanical, okay? They move the same way, pretty much. Let's just take liquidity out of the equation for a minute, because yes, if someone's dropped, we all know that, okay? So for the haters that are going to go, oh, liquidity, you don't know about liquidity. I know about liquidity, okay? I know about liquidity. But if you're doing 25 quid, 50 quid, 100 quid, it's not going to move the market that much, okay? It's really, really not. Not unless there's naff all in that market, okay? If you're dropping 40 grand, that's going to move the market. For the average person, we don't need to worry about that just yet, okay? You will learn that. You'll see those bets coming in. But for you, your own trading, we're just going to stick to very, very simple. There's very, very little difference between £2 and 25 quid or 50 quid going in, okay? So just get that out of your head. The difference is you. If you are trading £2 stakes right now, saying, when I get my dream bank of £2,000 and I'm going to then use 50 quid stakes, never going to happen, because the jump from you using £2 to £50 is massive mentally. And that is going to mess you up. Like, mess you up bigger and more than Jason Statham if you've just pinched his wife's bum. That you're going to get way more messed up from those stakes than Jason Statham is going to do to you. Just imagine what he would do to you if you did that. How angry you would be. Because you're not ready for those stakes. You're not ready for that massive, massive bank, because you don't have a profitable strategy that you can scale yet. And if you are dreaming of that, or you do have a profitable strategy that you are scaling, and you're going to scale it way too fast, what is going to happen when you drop those, that massive bank, that dream bank, is You're going to lose. The strategy won't work anymore. And then you'll blame the strategy. And actually, it's you. You are the problem, because it's a process. You have to build up gradually, 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 because you have to mentally be ready for the jump in stakes. You have to do that. If you go from £2 to £50 stakes, it's just going to mess you up, because what's going to happen is you're not going to think clearly, which is what the whole point of this video is. When you use money that you aren't ready to be using, all that you're going to see is those red numbers getting bigger and bigger and bigger and bigger, bigger than you've ever seen before. And your hopes and dreams are fading with that. They're just gone. And you're going, oh, and then that negative self-talk's got into your head. But you told yourself, when you got this big bank, this would be the big breakthrough that you needed. And it's wrong. You're wrong again. And then you start to put undue pressure upon yourself. Wrong. You don't need to do it. So stop it. Stop dreaming about when I have £2,000 in a Betfair account. Just forget it. Build up to that point. Okay. And how do you do that? Well, you build a profitable strategy and you scale it gradually. Now, if you only have 20 quid to spend on your Betfair bank, it doesn't matter. It's 20 quid. Use it. Okay. Use the same stakes over and over, 2-3% of that bank every single trade. Yes, I know the minimum is £1 on Betfair. Use software to get under it. Okay. There's plenty of other ways. Okay. Build up gradually. Okay. Because what's going to happen is compound interest, which is the eighth wonder of the world. It really, really is. Okay. Compound interest is going to be your friend. Compounding. Okay. What's going to happen is you use those stakes this month. You are profitable at those stakes. What is then going to happen at the end of that month is the next month, you're going to be using the same stakes. But because you've been profitable, built up slowly, your bank is going to be bigger. So you're going to be using slightly bigger stakes and so on and so forth, etc. Now, this works at every level. This works whether you have a £100 bank or £500 bank or even a £1,000 bank, okay? 2 to 3% of your bank, use it wisely, build it up gradually, 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 gradually. And that's it. That is it. So never, so stop it. Never think about, oh, I will be a good trader if I only I have my dream bank, okay? Because a fool and their money are soon parted. Yes, there are ways to add to your bank that don't involve profit, but it's a process. Build, 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 build. Okay, start with what you can afford to lose and build from that process. Let me know in the comments below. I know that Martin called me Rylan in another video. That cheeky beggar, Rylan, Martin, giving me a stick. Can't be having that. Cannot be having that. So yeah, let me know in the comments below what nickname, what pun, what, all those things that I can use for Martin. Let me know in the comments below and I will see you next week for another one of these videos. And please, 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 if there is a question you have, if there is a video that you want me to record, pop it in the comments below and I will get to it. Thank you very much.